Now we know how we can install a Laravel app and how we can start the server on Laravel application. So we just need to say php artisan serve, and this will start on localhost 8000. And then if I go to localhost 8000, we get this kind of page. That's very nice. But when you have the new Laravel application, there are lots of folders and files are there. So if you get overwhelmed by this kind of structure, don't worry about that. I'm going to dive into each and everything one by one. But the first question comes in my mind that we have just a fresh installation of Laravel. We have not done anything. We just have started server. So how we get these kind of things? The Laravel word is written. Some of the links are there. White background. How this is going to work and where this HTML is situated on this Laravel application. So we just need to figure out these things, and that's the entry point on our Laravel world. So you can see it's just a base URL, nothing else. This means in general core PHP, if you have abc.com, then what you do, you will search for index.php file. So let's just search for index.php. So I will press command P or control P on Windows, and I will say index.php. So yes, we have this index.php in public folder. So let's open public folder, and inside that we have index.php, and we are sure that yes, inside this we got the HTML. But you can see it just a PHP file, nothing else. Some of the things are written, but we don't have to care about these things for now. So this is not going to work, because this is not a core PHP, it's a framework, it's a Laravel, and this Laravel works totally differently and obviously efficiently. So what I recommend you to aside your core PHP knowledge when you are trying to learn Laravel, because to have these things, to have a base URL, we need to go to the first folder I'm going to introduce you is routes or roots, whatever you want to call. So this is the folder from where you can define all your URL or URI, whatever you call it. So we have four files: api.php, channels.php, console.php, and web.php. The first three, we will talk about them later when the time comes, but now it's time to learn about web.php file. If I open this file, we have a PHP tag, some of the comment about this file, and some kind of syntax. So yes, you can read this, but I'm not going to read it. So I will just remove it. And what I'm going to show you is that you can see we have a route keyword written, then some colon colon, and then get. This is actually creating a route for our application, and that route having a request of get. That means a get method. This function get require two parameters. One is first the URI of your route, like you have base URL here, so you can say about, or you can say contact, these kind of things. And the next is what you want to do when you hit this, or when the user hit this URI. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to just comment this one, and I'm going to say dump, and inside this working. So I'm going to say dump and working. So let's go here and refresh. And yes, you can see we are having working dumped here. This is because we had this base URL, slash means base URL. So this means whatever you do inside this function will reflect when user hit this route. And by default, they are returning a view. View of name welcome. So that's why if I uncomment it, go refresh this page. Yes, we have all these things, this HTML. But the next question comes in my mind, where this view is situated, or where this welcome is situated. So the next folder I'm going to introduce you with is resources folder, because inside this resources folder you have this views. So whenever you call using this helper function called view, it will look whatever you type inside the parameter from this views folder. And yes, you can see inside this views folder we have a file called welcome.blade.php. But wait, we said we want just welcome view, not welcome.blade.php. So actually Laravel uses a blade syntax or blade template engine to format or to have more power on our HTML. That's why it is welcome.blade.php, not just welcome.php. This means we can use PHP and obviously blade on this file. And that's why, because every view is suffixed with .blade.php, that's why we are not going to define. Yeah, it's obvious that if we are trying to access any view, name is welcome, that means it is suffixed with .blade.php. So we are not going to say that. This means if we are returning a view of welcome, this is the file or content of this file is going to returned. So I'm sure this Laravel and these links are inside this welcome.blade.php. So let's open this file, and yeah, we have the doc type, that means simple HTML markups, and we have stylings. Scroll down to the body part and then you can simply see we have written Laravel and all these links. That means we are on the correct file. So to prove that this is the actual file, instead of Laravel, I'm going to say Bitfumes. Save this file and go refresh. And yes, you can see it is now changed to Bitfumes instead of Laravel. So this is the first thing I'm going to show you, is that you can simply return a view from any route. So let's just do one thing. Let's try to create a new route. So I will say route colon colon get, and inside single quotes I will say about. You can use slash about or simply about, doesn't matter. Then say function and then close this line. Returning view, everything is same, we are just going to return a new view called about. So what if I try to access about page right now? So if I say about on the slash about, hit enter. Okay, we are having this error. And you can see this is more customized and more user-friendly error message. This error message is came, or this is actually formatted by using whoops. In Laravel, there is a package called whoops, which is going to customize and make user-friendly error messages just like this. And the message is just saying one thing, view about not found. And that's exactly what we know. We are returning a view called about, but we don't have any file inside our views folder called about.blade.php. So what if I can create about.blade.php? So let's say about.blade.php file, and I will simply say here, this is about, no HTML, nothing else, just for testing, this is about. So if I go, yes, we have a whoops error message, but if I refresh this page, error message is gone, and now we have this is about, because now our about route is working and it is returning this view called about. And again, if I delete this, try to access this about page, and we get this error. And as I told you, this is because of a package called whoops. And if you go inside this package.json file, you can see whoops 2.0. That's the package only required for development. So this means this message is going to show only when you are developing, not on the production. And how this is going to work, we will see later, but this is very important thing. So congratulations, you have created your first route, your first view, and Now from the next episode, we will go deep dive into some of the new concepts. So till then, goodbye. And if you want to learn new things and work on real projects, then head over to bitfumes.com/courses section, because here we have all the Udemy paid courses and some of the premium courses for this website only. So you can just subscribe to this website with little amount to unlock everything. All the videos are ad free and hello hi free. This means just pure learning. So keep learning and keep watching. We will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.